Hi, it's Mike from Custom Cruise. You can see here we've got quite a big job on. We're fitting the Thunderheart loom. You can see here with all the LEDs built in. We're just doing the rear indicators, okay. What I'm doing, I'm not putting the plugs on yet. These wires are definitely correct. So I've checked on the Thunderheart loom. I've written on what we're gonna do here, okay. And I've tested stuff using this battery, which is off the bike, obviously. And this is your red. Well, it's black for some reason in America, but this should be red and is live. And these are your various VFI looms. We've got a S&S VFI going on here, fuel pump, you know, and these are to the injectors, etc. Where you can see front and rear injectors, and then your mass airflow sensor, all your others, temp sensor, etc. This obviously gives you a bit more. This will come up here. Okay. Like a salt. And then this wire will obviously be hidden away as well. Heat shrunk to the rest. But you can see here, we've got the indicators done. It's been quite a big job because we've got to run, this is the plug. And obviously the outer plug will go on as well, but we're just going to run it like that. But you can see here, very cool. The indicators go along and through these loops, okay, and then up there, right? And this is all waterproof. These are Kellerman, amazing indicators, very expensive, but my god, they're cool. This is fully legal. Look how big my finger is. Stop, tail, run, everything all built in one, okay. Very, very cool bit of kit. Now, what I've done with this, I've checked all my wiring, so I can actually put the outer plugs on, but I personally like to leave them loose because when I put these on, okay, this obviously will push in and the thing goes in the middle. In fact, that's a six, it's a four, but this one, yeah, this one will go on here, okay. Well, they'll be pushed up the back, you know, and then it'll be sealed in, okay, and go right up and fully waterproof, being Deutz. Okay, these wires here, still got to sort all these out. Live, a lot of these are going to the ignition switch, which is actually on the other side. We've got a headlamp connector here, okay, so that's going to go up to this headlamp connector on this awesome fucking Springer. It really is an awesome machine, but we're fitting a gear drive on it. It's got a hydraulic clutch. This is your S&S VFI loom, so we're actually fitting a full S&S VFI injection on it. This was originally a canbus bike, so you can imagine how many of these plugs we've used. So we've converted it from canbus to basically run on a normal loom. Okay, canbus is a bit of a nightmare. If, you know, I'm a qualified electronics guy, and it is a nightmare. These are the wires for the ignition switch, which we've got to decide where we put them. The indicator is exceedingly cool. They'll fit under here, if you can see that, but they are very, very cool. And they will fit up under there. And they, again, are fully legal. Bright amber, very, very bright, okay. Here's all the wiring for the speedos and everything, right. These mirrors, believe it or not, are actually a complete, they're made by Badlands. And this actually has all the digital information in it. And the instructions are down here. So it looks pretty complex. I say luckily I've done all the lasers and shit in the army, so, you know, digital gauge mirrors, you can see it's critical the ground connection, you know, left side, right side, you know, taco, left side, speedo. Absolutely amazing bit of kit. This is your S&S VFI loom, okay. So this, to say, again, it goes to the ignition switch, which we're going to locate. These here, we got here, low beam, high beam, okay. Pretty simple if you do it this way, where you literally, every wire is labeled. This is red, I don't know why the loom, it's black. Black is normally an earth in the UK. But on this particular case, this is actually live, which is a bit frightening to have that black. You know, these are more of the VFI connectors, okay? Speedo sensor, whatever that's for. This here will be run up the top. This will be your rear light, just for the number plate. Very cool custom cycle components light. Okay, very, very cool bit of kit. Very expensive, but solid billet. You know, I've got to admit, this really is a nice bit of kit. What else we got going on? Yeah, masses of Deutz plugs. We got these crimpers, and we've also got sort of your pucker. These are the proper ones, if you like. You know, cost a lot more money, but these are very good. You can actually swap the bits in here as well. The strip is automatic as well, so if we put this on a wire, I'll have to do it that way. Can you see that? Literally just do that and it's off. It's so easy to use these automatics. See, it holds the wire and then strips it. Fantastic bit of kit. Okay, but massive job. We've converted this basically from a full canbus bike to these mini push buttons, which I've got to wire up as well off this lot. Sorry, they're the speedos. These are the wires out of the switch gear. Okay, so these are out of the switch gear, as you can see. And all these wires obviously will be run way out of the way. And heat shrunk up as well. You know, at the moment they're all naked. Till I know they're right, I will not heat shrink anything. Okay, this has obviously been heat shrunk, so I know this is good. This goes to the headlamp, and then the headlamp, obviously the wires will run across here. But this one here, right hand indicator, there the, yeah, they're the out and ins. And this one here, left hand indicator. Okay, so although it looks a mess, if you've done electronics like I have in the forces, thermal imaging, tank lasers, God knows what, it actually isn't that big a job. You know, I can't use computers and I'm shit at building, but this is definitely my forte. Now, what you'll see on this bike, unfortunately, the owner has bought these ridiculously long 4-inch at least, if not more, over forks. Now you can see here, that's on the bottom hole and it's still nowhere near. Okay, so we'll have to get a billet bracket made that's going to drop right down so this thing actually reaches the deck, or get a longer stand if one is available. I'm not actually sure. Get shorter ones. Beautiful American suspension forks. We've put this billet light on, you know, cracking light. All top stuff. Very, very cool bike. A lot of work. It's been a bloody nightmare. All the Nest Ford controls and stuff, as you can see, beautifully made. This particular bike had the heads left off it like it is now for 4 years. Therefore, there's quite a bit of work to be done to the motor from what I can see as well. But this is for your ECU. This will fit on here. And this is this protective stuff that I put over the paint. Okay, it's like a fablon, I suppose you could call it. They use it on cars for spoilers. And all this lot will all be secured in here. The Thunderheart will actually be here in the front. The battery will obviously go in. And being an Odyssey, it will turn anything over, you know, up to about 2.4 litres. So there's no problem at all with that. Okay, if you're interested in any great stuff, fat spoke wheels, for instance, I've powder coated these black. Originally, they unfortunately been left out and had gone rusty. But if you're interested, give us a call. 01773 83566, customcruisers.com or the new site, customcruisers.eu. Thank you.